und der Sicht meistens heute.
Okay. How does it feel at the end of a day like that? Do you like your job in an evening like that?
I love my job, but I hate talking to people like you.
Thanks.
No, do you mean? I love it right now because I said earlier on, you're the last person I'm talking to, so you probably get the best interview, darling, don't I?
I mean, the whole thing like this afternoon when you have to talk to so many journalists, what goes
inside? Well, it's part of my job, so I have to do it. We don't do it that often, so I mean, it's like, this is the first kind of press conference we've had for a long while, you know, 3, 4, 5 years maybe. So I don't mind it. If I had to do this every day, forget it.
Do you sometimes have the feeling that, I mean, obviously people are asking the same questions all the time, that it's
your
music is your statement and not the talking?
No, I think it's more than music, you know, we're personalities, so you talk about more than music. I mean, if all you talked about was music, depending on if you're a music paper, then you talk about music. But there's more to us than just writing songs. I mean, we do other things and we have characters and depends what you talk about. So I don't mind it. No. And of course people ask the same questions because some of the questions are current and they want to know about the same things. So ask me about my solo album then, huh?
Yeah, what about your solo album?
Oh, it's great.
Of course it is. Does it sound a bit different?
Yes, it sounds...
I heard you had a break.
Hopefully it's not finished yet, see, so I don't know how it's going to come out. But at the moment I've worked on it for about 2 months, 2 or 3 months, and I was supposed to finish it before the Queen tour, but I need a bit more time. And it's sounding good. It's nice to actually play with different people, because I've always played with Queen all the time, and so I had a, you know, there's a drummer from, the session drummer from Munich, and a guitarist from Munich, so basically all German players, and it's made my song sound different, you know.
To people outside, it sometimes feels funny that, or special, that there are so many solo projects, whereas the band is still going as well on the side. How would you analyze the influence of the solo stuff for the band when you come back together again? Is that an advantage that you are four strong writers who also do stuff on your own, or does it?
Yes, I think. In a funny way, I thought, because I think this is one of the few groups that all four members write, and I thought that we'd be doing solo albums much before this. But I think, in a funny way, when we do a Queen album, they're like four solo projects within themselves anyway, because, I mean, I have my bunch of songs, Brian has his, and Roger and John, and so it's like four little solo projects working side by side, and then we put them all together. So I think that was the reason that we didn't actually go and do solo projects earlier on. I mean, if we were writing all the same kind of songs, then we would have gotten fed up and said, oh, I want to do my solo album first. But we're all writing different songs, so it keeps us interested. So for, what, about 13 years or whatever, you know, that was interesting enough for us to carry on. And as far as I was concerned, all Queen albums were little solo projects anyway. I was writing my kind of songs that I wanted. But now I think the time has come where I want a whole album of my own, and Roger's done two already, so I think most people thought that I would be the first one to have a solo album, and then the band, you know, Queen would break up and all that, but here you are, after 13 years, four old ladies are still rocking away.